everyone, it's Mike Ball from WordPress.com. Today we're just going to look at how you would add an email using one of your domains. So if I wanted a donations at pingolife.com, or I wanted a drummer at thehuntsoloproject.com, or just Mike at thatmikeball.com, how would I go about doing that? WordPress.com actually makes it pretty easy compared to some of the sites I've tried to do this on before. So if we go in, we're in my home, I've got the Han Solo project selected. You can see that here. I'm just gonna scroll down, and if I hover over this upgrade section right here, you're gonna see I have an email option right here. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on that. That's gonna take me to an email kind of page where I can choose how I wanna do this. So obviously it's gonna give me a chance to put in the email that I want. So we'll set this up. It'll have me change a password for it, which is fine. It's going to use my WordPress.com password. Oh, no. Look, your password reset email is there, and it's going to use the password that I have in place already. And you can see down here, this is what's powered by what's called Titan Mail, which is a really cool project. I like it a lot. You can also use Google Workspace, and that's $72 per year. So versus what this will be is a first renewal is $26.25 after the trial, or normally it's $35 per year. So it's about just under half of what Google Workspace is. I'm gonna do this for now. If you really wanna use Google Workspace or using other Google tools, that one works too. So let's try this out. It says create your mailbox. So I'm gonna go ahead and check out, which is pretty easy. Save your information. So it's going to give an email for confirmation, which I'll do in a different tab. It's going to ask me to download a copy if I want, yada yada. So this is just kind of your basic setup flow. And I'm going to grab that email from a different tab so you don't see my inbox. I already have it. And it has a button essentially that says access web mail. So what I'm gonna do is drag this over. There goes drummer at grab my password from my password manager. I think it's this one. Or it could be. Let's see here. Here we go. Okay. Confirm password recovery email. So that's just where it would send an email if you forget your password and need to verify it. All right, so now it's gonna take me, this is kind of the onboarding flow that we're gonna get. So what's pretty cool about Titan that you don't really get from Gmail, they have some of this, but not all of it. Email templates. So if you're not sure, like you have to send a certain type of email, whether it's for work or for just your personal uses, there's nice templates that have been tested and work well in here that you can leverage. Email tracking, know if people opened it or not, which is cool if you're running a business and doing outreach and you wanna see if people are actually interested in what you're doing. You could set reminders for yourself. So if you get an email that you don't wanna respond to right now, but you don't wanna forget, you can circle back. Or if you send an email, you wanna say, oh, if I don't hear back in X number of days, remind me to follow up on that. And then you can schedule sending. So if you're working at weird hours or something like that, or you don't want something to go out right away, you can do that. So go in here and get that set up. I like using Batmike for display names because I'm a Batman fan or nerd, whatever you want to call me. I'll set my signature later. You can connect it to a Gmail account if you want to, which is kind of cool. It'll bring in your existing emails and everything to it, which is nice. I'll set that up later too. And then you can get an app separately to manage, which is pretty sweet. So really this is I don't want to say it's easy, but it's a pretty guided, structured onboarding process for the email tool. And it doesn't take a lot of work to get things set up. once you're in here, it's a normal inbox like you would expect for a lot of email tools, just like going to gmail.com or something. And that's going to remind me, if you see that down there, it'll ask me to go through this kind of process to make sure I have everything set up. And it's going to give me this little progress bar down here to tell me how far into that I am. And then along with your normal inbox and sent and spam folders and stuff, it'll show you if you have anything scheduled, and it'll let you manage multiple accounts in here, which is pretty sweet. Now, that was probably the fastest I think I've ever seen an email set up for a domain without having to take multiple steps. So that's pretty easy overall. It's a little bit different with Workspace just to connect it to Google accounts and everything, but it's still super easy. So if you're thinking about it, but you're kind of avoiding it because you're worried it's going to be technically difficult or something like that, don't. It's just a couple clicks through, and then it'll guide you through how to get your account set up and start letting people send you emails, and you start sending out emails from that account. Once you're in, I believe, you can even see your emails in your dashboard too. So if I go to my inbox, this is usually forms and things like that you can get, but you can connect your email right to it. So if you ever are on WordPress.com and you're trying to access your email, you want to access your email that's associated with your domain, all you have to do is go to inbox and you can access that right there, which is pretty sweet. So if you have any questions, let us know. Otherwise, give it a try. Set up an email. If your personal inbox is getting too crowded, full of random things that are tied to your different projects or work, it's nice to have a separate account for that, and it's easy to switch between them. Whether you're in Google Workspace or Titan, you can connect your different accounts and manage them in the same space. Like I said, there's some cool different tools with that Titan email inbox that you should try out with the templates and everything else too. So give it a try and let us know what you think.